This is the Daymak Beast Deluxe. It's sort of the second level in their Beast series, launched in 2015. It's awesome. There are actually three choices. The entry level one I've reviewed as well. It's $19.99. This one's $29.99, so it's an extra $1,000. And what you're getting is lithium ion batteries. This pack, it only weighs like 31 pounds versus 62 on the other one. And you're getting a lot more capacity, 60 volts, 20 amp hours. So that's a huge step up right there. You're also getting LED lights. You're getting a faster battery charger right here. This is 3 amp versus 2.5. So, you know, not a ton faster, but it's also sort of metal and it's got these LED readouts. Very nice. And then an upgraded saddle. So, you know, for $1,000, it's definitely a big step up. But otherwise, much of the bike is sort of unchanged. It's the same frame, kind of comes in this one size, black, looks nice. Single speed drivetrain right here. So pedaling this, you know, technically it's possible, but I wouldn't want to pedal it too much because this is still about 200 pounds, this thing. And a lot of that weight is just the huge suspension. We've got almost like automotive grade hydraulic disc brakes. It's like 215 millimeters on that front rotor. Also definitely a nicer rotor than on the standard Beast. And then these big tires and everything. So you can kind of see here, they're like 21 by 7. And if you think about fat tire bicycles, those are like 3 inches wide. So 7 inches, I mean, it's, you know, it's huge. You've got this nice tread. It's gonna give you plenty of traction. These oversized, just big kind of fenders, front and rear. So you're not gonna have too much mud hitting the frame and hopefully not hitting your person. Having a smaller diameter on these wheels really empowers the motor. This is a 500 watt direct drive gearless motor. Since the wheel is sort of smaller, it doesn't have to turn this huge thing and basically you're getting better leverage. So that's something I comment on when I'm reviewing like folding electric bikes and stuff. And it makes sense on something like this as well. A lot of times with a smaller diameter wheel though, you sort of fall into bumps and stuff, and that's why having something that's super wide here and also a little bit taller is gonna help you. And then the suspension here, we've got this swing arm on the rear. Very nice, little kind of a chain guard there for you to keep you kind of clean. Really, in my opinion, the pedals are, they're just to qualify it as sort of a low-speed electric bike so that technically you could ride it on some trails or not have to have a license or insurance. The top speed on this ships at about 20 miles per hour. I think you can go faster than that, especially with the larger battery pack. So you really have to make your own decisions about where to ride this. I think a lot of it would be done off-road. I saw these at Burning Man and it was awesome. It was really exciting because it was like, man, this thing is solar powered. You're out in the desert. Like, you don't have electricity unless you brought a generator. Like, this is such a cool thing. The solar is definitely an exciting aspect. However, you know, it's somewhat limited. It's going to take several days of trickle charging to actually charge the battery. And that's why, of course, it comes with a traditional charger. But at least it has it. And that's going to keep it from completely discharging and potentially damaging those cells. Just a really cool feature. I like that they did that. But, you know, while you're riding, your feet might be covering it up and stuff too. So it's a little bit for show. Definitely kind of a unique show though, something that I don't see a lot. You got the rack for utility back here. I didn't see like brazons or anything, but you could always use strapping for kind of like a saddlebag or maybe even some sort of panniers, but you wouldn't want them to drop too low. There aren't really any blockers, so they could kind of get sucked in or kind of bump off of that fender. Love that it's got, you know, full lighting integrated. And again, LED lights on this one. So you've got turn signals front and back, and they're kind of the, you know, bouncy ones. So if you hit something off road, they're not going to break. Kind of almost like a motorcycle headlight on the front. Looks really good. People are going to see you. There's even like a little horn. I'm going to go ahead and just turn this on. So here we got like running lights and then the headlight. Let's see it there lighting up. Very nice. Let's hit that horn. We've got, yeah, just very annoying. But it's, you know, it's got it. We got the rear view mirrors and they're adjustable too. So I, on one of the Beasts earlier, we were riding around and kind of had it vertical so you could see a longer track behind you. Let's see, we got people riding around out here. It's so much fun to ride something like this, get off road and have that peace and quiet. You're not gonna disturb the wildlife as much. So if you're like bird watching or maybe you're just cutting through someone's land, it's private property and you don't want to get shot, I mean, this would be a great option for that, and I'm not condoning it. So turn signals, there we go. If you go left and then right, it actually turns on the hazards, which is really cool. And then you press the little white thing to release it, just like a motorcycle. Got your brights up here. Here's the display panel. It's actually, you know, pretty well protected. You can see there's like this case covering on it. I kind of like that because I can imagine going through mud with this and getting a little bit dirty. Oh, and by the way, the pedals, they fold so they can completely stay out of the way, or you can just take them off if you want. Anyway, back to the display. It's just a monochrome backlit, sort of a light blue glow, but it works pretty well. It's really easy to read. We've got 5 levels of battery level charge going on. We've got a sort of like a ambient temperature here, 22 degrees Celsius, voltage 64. So this one's like almost completely full. Speed, kilometers per hour, and then odometer down here. So good stuff. And of course, when you activate the turn signals and stuff, that shows up here as well. You do have to have the key in when riding. It's a lot like a motorcycle or something, but you know, it stays pretty much out of the way. You're not going to kick it or anything up at the front. And then this down here, if you watch the other review, you'll notice this is different. This is actually a second controller, because this is a Beast D that we're looking at right now, meaning it has double motors. So there's a 500 watt motor in the rear, same thing up front, 500 watts. So it's 1,000 watts overall. And again, that might change how it's classified in your state. I think in California, it's okay to have a 1,000 watt electric bike, but in certain other locales, it would have to be off-road. And you know, this is a perfect example of what that means. We're just out on some land, having fun, cruising around. Keep that in mind. Again, this upgrade here, instead of like $29.99 for a standard deluxe, we're talking like $42.99. So, you know, there's significant cost, but they build it in and everything. I think they do sell a kit aftermarket if you want to convert it, but it'd be quite a bit of work. You need the special tools and stuff. And when you're ready for that all-wheel drive, you click this little switch to on. And that's going to be great for someone who's maybe a little bit heavier. You know, I only weigh like 135 pounds or something like that. This thing does just fine, even in rear-wheel drive for me with the bigger battery pack. But yeah, for someone who's like 200 plus pounds and doing a lot of steep hill riding, the dual motors is great. You know, you just get more traction. You're gonna be able to go through different terrains, sand and stuff a little bit easier, or this kind of brush. So I think that's great. Here's a close-up of the seat. And I did wanna call out that it's got quick release on both sides here, so the whole saddle thing kind of slides up and down. Again, there's only one frame size. The handlebars aren't especially adjustable. This is just about giving you some more like leg clearance and stuff. And I find myself like kind of standing up when I ride sometimes too, to absorb shock. So yeah, good feedback, I guess, about how this thing is ridden. I'm here with Blaine, actually. How's it going, buddy?
Not bad, thanks. How are you?
I'm great, man. You know, thank you for your help. His friend owns some of the land around here, and you've had fun experimenting with these on your own time.
Yeah, I come here quite often.
Yeah, well, I would love help today, just like maybe showing me how that battery works.
Yeah,
if we
no
can
problem.
It's like we take this same key.
Take the same key. Unlock.
Here, pop off that top bracket. And by the way, that's the other controller back there. So that's the one that traditionally...
So then I just unplug the power supply to the motor.
Okay.
And these straps here help you to lift this out.
Yeah.
But otherwise, it does have handles on both sides.
Yeah.
As you can see here.
Love that.
And this is your 110 outlet.
Cool.
So you can plug this in and watch TV for 5-6 hours if the power goes out.
Love it, yeah.
Okay. When you put it on number one, that'll give you your trickle charge.
Mm-hmm.
And number two is just regular
for riding.
Zero is off. Yeah, powers it off. So you have your
USB charger ports
here as well.
And then there's another charging port for the charger.
You can
charger.
Just plug the charger directly into here, or there's another one of those on the other side of the bike.
Just check that out. So, yeah, what you're saying is you don't have to take the battery off to charge it.
So you can just plug the charger into here.
Okay. So my advice for lithium batteries, especially, you know, if you want to prolong the life, the best thing to do is just kind of avoid those extreme temperatures, extreme cold, extreme heat. Just try to keep it in like a cool, dry, like a closet location or something. If you're not riding for a long time, maybe leave it about half charged so you're not stressing the cells at one end or the other. And that kind of care and just foresight can help to extend this and help it last. The Beast comes with a year-long warranty that's on the frame and the motors. If you get the D. Otherwise, everything else on it, including the battery, is about 6 months. But the lithium battery is going to last longer than the sealed lead acid on the other entry-level Beast. And then they have like an Ultimate Beast, by the way, that's even more expensive, and it's got another upgraded battery, even brighter lights, and it could potentially even go faster. So that's like a good quick roundup, I think, and might be fun to take this thing out and actually ride it around.
Yeah,
so
let's do it.
I'm gonna hop on this thing and get some footage, and I think Blaine will be helping out.
This one also has the pedal assist on it as well.
Yeah, that's, you know, I was looking at that.
I took my kids to school the other day, and I just pedaled very, very light pedaling, and just pulls itself. So the pedal assist, there's a sensor here.
Yeah, it's a 12 sensor, just double checking that. So, you know, very responsive in terms of starting and stopping. And I neglected to mention that these brake levers also do have a motor inhibitor, which I think is, I mean, that's like the legal standard in a lot of places, but that way you're not accidentally fighting the motors, especially the 500 watt motor like this, if you accidentally continue to pedal when you want to stop. So it's a good safety feature. Yeah, sweet, thank you. So Blaine's riding up this way. He's like 195 pounds, so it's, you know, a little bit more weight than me. Look at that, climbing the hill. Sweet. Look at that suspension, definitely going off. Great to have, again, with those smaller wheels and just some of the obstacles we have here. So I think I'm gonna hop on and try to demonstrate what it's like from a riding perspective. We're using the center stand right now, but there's also the side stand, and it actually has another motor inhibitor, so they've been really good about safety so you don't accidentally activate this thing. Oh, here he comes again. Hey, very nice, man. Thank you. Yeah, look at this thing. You've definitely had your... Oh, and you've got the camo stickers.
Yeah, this is mine. I've put 256.7 kilometers on this one already.
Oh my gosh.
As you can see on the display.
Yeah, dude. Were you in? You were in all-wheel drive doing that,
yeah,
too,
it was,
huh?
Yeah, I could do it in just rear, but I prefer that on the rough stuff.
It's good to have for the extra
the hills and stuff,
strength, climbing.
Torque, yeah.
Yeah. Thank you. I'm gonna go ahead and try to get this one off the stand. There we go. Just go ahead and activate it like that.
Would you like to go in the trailer over here and show you? Or?
Yeah, I'll try to follow. I might actually hook up my other camera real quick to do that though. Let me just, I'll get some shots with this and then we'll go do that. I'm gonna go ahead and hit the dual motors as well. Just gonna coast down this hill. Take it out on some nice flatter terrain. Oh yeah. Real sense of power here. For sure. Whoa. I'm always nervous about those bumps. They feel pretty good. Woo! It's fun and it's quiet. I think I just swallowed a bug. Go ahead and try the pedal assist thing. I can hardly get it started. I think I'm gonna have to use the throttle. Yeah, the pedal assist just isn't really very useful. I'm really not able to pedal too well with the one-handed here. And instead of being limited at 20 miles per hour or 32 kilometers per hour, the Deluxe, it can go up to like 50 kilometers per hour. So we're talking, you know, something like 30 miles per hour. And you definitely feel the extra power. You've got the range and the lithium battery pack. Yeah, appreciate the props. Let's do it. On.
Can you take the light one? Yeah, I mean, you're left.
Here we go. Whoa. Oh! Sweet. Oh, the brakes work great down that. Nice. There it is. Nice and handy. I want to see the turn signals. Yeah. Hey.
I went the other way.
That's awesome. Sweet. Okay, I'll click off the turn signal and then you want to lead on, Blaine? Yeah. Go. Oh yeah, handle that. Sweet. Oh man, really putting it through its paces here. Those big tires, it's great traction.
What?
So this is Fred, this is your place, right? You got an awesome ATV here, but as you can hear, sorry, you know, there's more noise. This is, it goes further and it's pretty powerful, but it's gas powered. So, you know, that was one of the things that's so cool about the Beast. Or, you know, other electric vehicles is that they tend to be a little quieter and you want to get some peace and, you know, maybe see some birds or something. So thank you. Sorry to, no hate, man.
Where are you from?
Colorado.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Beautiful country down there, man.
It really is, you know, but I got to say, you got a slice of paradise here, man.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Thanks for letting us come out and try out the Beast. Cheers. And by contrast, I'm just gonna hop on one of these and, you know, again, see if you can hear the noise produced. Awesome. That is the Daymak Beast Deluxe, and this one is actually the D, so it's got the double motors, but really cool. I think even though it's, you know, like 50% more expensive for those lithium-ion batteries, I noticed a big difference in terms of power, top speed and everything as well. It's a really cool vehicle, you know, and even though the solar, to me, it's like, meh, you know, if I use this every few days, you know, and I was parking it outside, I could see it coming in handy, but just don't expect it to charge like overnight or anything, especially not overnight. So anyway, for the full write-up on the Deluxe and other Daymak Beast products and other light electric vehicles, I'll see you back at ElectricRideReview.com. Ride safe.